Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Modo Mads. I'm your editor Maddie. Hope you are doing great. Today we are going to do installation DIY of the fourth product from Luvia, which is shadow stays of D-Guard for our Dominar 400. So let's unbox along with my darling Kushi. Kushi, open. Open, Che. Batko.
Dance, window, draw. Nanny.
Hi, Chappu. Flankish. Here you go. So this is a complete setup of D-Guard saddle stays. I will show you where all these parts get fitted onto our Dominar. This is completely powder coated MS product and this looks absolutely cool.
This D-Guard saddle stays costed me around 3,350 rupees along with GST. If you missed my old installation DIY vlogs, I am giving all the links in my description below. You can check that. And also in my next screen, I am going to show all the Dominar 400 and Dominar 250 saddle stays options which are available in market.
We do have 5 noticeable brands in this saddle stay segment. First one is Zana. It costs 2900 rupees, Hyper Rider 2190, Banados 1990 rupees. The fourth one is Sahyadri. It costs 3250 rupees. We do have 2 models in Luvia. I have opted D-Guard, which costs 3570 rupees due to its looks.
So let's go down and fix this beautiful D-Guards on my Leo Dominar 400. This is our Leo. We are going to install this D-Guard saddle stays on my Dominar 400. So this D-Guard takes support from this grab rails and one support is from this footrest. Let's open seat first. We require this type of toolbox to do all these small maintenance works and this installation kind of work on our bike.
Now we are opening these 2 grab rails. For that we require 6mm Allen key. I'm not going to use this torque wrench. I will open with this. The reason behind using this wrench is we may require some more torque to open this. So these are the spacers and this is the holder which get installed at the place of grab rails. They have given 2 spacers to increase the height of this grab rail or else it will foul with this plastic body. Always tight opposite to opposite. Same procedure need to be repeated at another side also. Now we are going to fix this seat. It will not get fitted. The reason is we have lifted the height of this grab rail. So for that, Luvia has given these two spacers. Let's fix it on our lock. We require 10 mm disc panel to open this locking unit. So this is how the locking unit looks like. We used to open this once in a while. Why don't we clean this? So these are the spacers. You can say it as razors. I don't think this bolt's height will match this. So definitely Luvia has given these bolts. Let's check. Yes, they have given this lengthy bolts of 6 mm. I'm not going to throw all these bolts. It may be useful for some other purpose. We require 5 mm Allen key to fix these bolts. Final torque I'm giving with this plain lens. I am unable to fix this seat. The reason is here we have provided 3 spacers and here 2. So I am adding 2 more spacers in between the lock and the plate. Now let's assemble all these parts on our D-guard. These are the 2 bolts which we need to fix these. We require 4 mm Allen key to fix this. 5 mm nuts. This is completely foolproof design. We cannot use these bolts in some other places. Thanks to Luvia R&D development team. So this is how it looks after fixing. I have used 5 mm bolts here. So we need to fix this here and this gets fixed on the footrest. Always washers need to be used along with the nut. 10 mm disc panel. We need to hold these nuts because they have given 9 lock nuts. It will not really rotate. We do not use this 10 mm disc panel. I'm not tightening it completely because we have to adjust here to fix this bolt onto the slot. Already we have installed this Luvia footrest, or else we have to use these bolts to fix this clamp onto the slot. So this old bolt itself we are using to fix this. So this is how it looks. We have to fix this 8 mm bolt into the slot. We used to get the D type of rhombus type of spacer to fix this here. Already have installed this Luvia footrest, so I'm not using that thing. Now I'm not tightening all the bolts completely. After fitting all these things all together, we'll tighten. Now the same thing we will repeat at another side also. To align this, I have opened pinion seat and loosened this grab rail, now adjusted and again fixing back. Now this spacer is given for, now this spacer is given to install along with this connecting rod which connects both the D-guards.
we need to fix this connecting rod which connects both these digards.
We need to apply some pressure to fix this connecting rod. If you are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe and press the bell icon. If you like this video, please like, comment and share it to your friends. Jai Hind. Hello everyone, I'm going to install this. Welcome to my YouTube channel Moto Mads. I'm your Rudder Maddy. Hope you all are doing great. Today we are going to do installation DIY of Kuchamma, please. Cut it.